Hey, in this video, I'm going to show you how to use JSP declarations. JSP declarations basically allow you to declare a method in the JSP page, and then you can call the method from the same JSP page. So it's very useful like any normal code that you create. If you need to execute some code over and over again, you simply encapsulate it in a method declaration. And you can do a similar thing here with JSP. And the syntax is basically an angle bracket percent with an exclamation point, and then you declare your method like any normal Java method. All right, so let's take a look at an example here of a JSP declaration. Up top, I'm going to declare a method. So again, declarations, angle bracket percent with an exclamation point. So once you're inside of here, this is just like a normal Java method declaration. You have the return type of string, the name of the method, make it lower, any input parameters. In this case, I have string data. And then internally inside the body, you write your actual implementation code. So in this example, my implementation code is going to be real simple. For make it lower, I'll simply take the data and call .to lowercase. And again, very trivial method here. Just wanted to show you how to declare a method in a JSP page. And then at the bottom, I can make use of that method. So here I'll have make use of a JSP expression. I do an angle bracket percent with an equal symbol, and I say make it lower, and I pass in the string that I wanted to convert. And that's it. So at the bottom here, this is what the output will look like. So lowercase hello world, and then colon, and then I have the actual hello world. So the result of making that expression or that method call, the results will be displayed right here in that JSP page. And that's basically it. Let's talk about some best practices. This follows what I discussed earlier with scriptlets. Similar thing here. You want to minimize the number of declarations in a JSP page and also avoid dumping thousands of lines of code in the JSP. Also, you want to refactor this into separate Java classes or make use of MVC. And I'll cover all of that later in the course. So in general, don't overdo it with JSP declarations. Let's move into Eclipse, and I want to continue to use the existing project, JSP Demo. And what I'd like to do is move down to this web content folder, and I'm going to add a new file. So I'll simply do a right click, I'll say new file. So I'm going to create this new file. The name of the file, I'll call it declarationtest.jsp. And once you're happy with the file name, you can go ahead and click finish. All right, so here's our file. It's empty. We need to add some code here. So I'll start off with my normal HTML and body. And now what I'd like to do is actually declare a method. So I use the JSP syntax, the angle bracket percent with the exclamation point. So at this point, I can actually start writing normal Java code. So I'm going to write a Java method. So here the return type of string, method name of make it lower, input data of string. And inside, I'll actually write the real implementation code. And again, this very trivial example, I'll just say data.to lowercase. And that's really it for this method declaration. So again, with JSP, you make a declaration by using the angle bracket percent with the exclamation point. Okay, great. So we have the method declared. Now let's use this method. So here, I'll just have some text, lowercase. Actually, I'll say lowercase hello world. And then I'll make use of that JSP expression so I can call that method declaration. So I say make it lower and I pass in some data, call it hello world. And then there we go. So that's an example here of making a call to that method. And I call it by making use of a JSP expression. So the result of this method call here will be included right here in this page. All right, so let's go ahead and run the application. So I'll move over here to this file, declaration.jsp. I'll do a right click, and I'll say run as, run on server. And then the browser will come up with our result. So we have lowercase hello world, and then we have, of course, the lowercase version of the hello world string. And that's it, and that's the result of our JSP expression making a call to our method that we declared using a JSP declaration. Good. So we kind of pulled it all together with a nice little example. Good job. All right, so let's go ahead and wrap up this video. So in this video, I showed you how to use JSP declarations. We created a declaration, and then we called that declaration from a JSP page.